Come here. It's gonna do something.
Wait. Let me get my camera.
Huh. Go slow. You might scare it.
Can you stop calling him an it?
Are we annoying cat people?
Yeah, you are. Oh, my little puppy.
It's like he's playing hard to get. Like he doesn't even care.
Yeah, maybe not about you. Oh my gosh, look how cute he is.
Oh my lord.
Oh, my little puppy. Hi.
Which one of these make me look intellectual?
Oh, you're gonna need more than a green tie look intellectual.
So yellow, then?
No, I'm serious. You know who your brother is.
I'm pretty sure he does not like me.
Oh no, it's not that he doesn't like you, it's just that, I don't know, he's probably still upset about what happened, you know?
I know what happened. He brings up what happens every single time I see him.
Okay, it's just dinner. Don't worry. What in the world is this? Yeah. It's not even Charles that I'm worried about, though. It's that drone, Trixie.
Drone? Oof.
You mean his fiance?
Oh, gag.
Aw, good to see you're already acting like sisters.
Every time I hear her voice, it makes me want to twat punch her.
Okay, yeah, you're kind of putting hot and psychotic right now.
Look good?
You do.
Thank you.
So now's probably a good time to tell you that I invited your sister to dinner tonight.
No, Zelda, not tonight. You've been at this for weeks. Can he take one night off? Are you done?
Morris, the play is this weekend. I gotta be prepared.
Yeah, it looks like you're working real hard.
Daniel Day-Lewis lived in a hole for 3 days to prepare for There Will Be Blood.
How about I toss you into a hole and see how prepared you are for that?
This could be the next step. The big one.
Yeah, you know, in this getup, you kind of look like Daniel Day-Lewis.
Dick.
Ow. No.
Boris, takeout's here. Zelda, you look great. You wearing that to dinner? Cool. Well, Charles is gonna be here in 5, so hurry the fuck up.
Immediately, m'lady.
God, I really need to get my own place.
Oh, the trailer in my backyard isn't Hollywood enough for you? This is a big dinner for me. Things between Lola's brother and I have been a little tense.
Yeah? Things are tense after you accidentally murder his dog?
Okay, I wouldn't call accidentally backing over a dog murder. It was an accident. Just don't bring it up, okay? Lola says Charles won't bring it up, so no jokes, yeah? Tonight is about having nice, normal conversations. Normal. Well, I'm just gonna say it. I need you not to make this about you.
You're a dog killer, and suddenly I'm the one with issues? Mm.
You have to admit, Zelda, you oftentimes gravitate toward the center of the attention.
fine. I'll be the perfect sister for Danae.
Call me crazy, but maybe just be yourself.
Fine. Just because you were kind of sweet there for a second. And while you and Dr. Awesome are talking about dead pets, I'll be looking after Trixie.
One more thing.
I'm gonna propose to Lola tonight.
Best behavior.
So I'm in Abu Dhabi, and then I get a call from Mark Cuban, so I have to fly to New York, and back to LA in less 3 days. So it's safe to say that between my software development and hopeful book deal, life's been pretty hectic.
And don't forget about the wedding planning. It's like he doesn't even care about the wedding. Yeah, it's like he'd rather be at work than with me.
So Zelda, why are you dressed like a man?
No, she's actually in a big play this weekend. You know, she's a lead, taking it real seriously. Method acting and whatnot.
Oh, you're big into method acting?
Mm, you are? Yeah. Oh, that's right. I forget. How many theater camps did you do? 3? Willingly? Yeah. You look electric.
Thank you.
Not you.
You know, the resilience is uncanny.
I know.
You know, if your shoulders were a little bit more wide, you could definitely pass for a young Val Kilmer who I'm playing golf with this weekend. Oh.
Cool. Who the hell is Val Kilmer?
I have no idea.
I love Charlie Chaplin.
Oh, really?
Yes! Did you know he was friends with Albert Einstein?
Actually, I didn't know that.
Well, I have this funny fascination for historical figures.
You seem like it tastes very good.
Oh, excuse me?
You seem like you have very good taste, you know, in historical figures.
Oh, well, thank you.
And so while I was making this cake, something really nasty fell in it, and I checked, and I didn't...
So anyway, guys, if you don't mind, I want to say a few words.
What are you doing?
Trust me. Please don't. Lola, I know how family is important to you, to us. And I know you would like everybody to be...
You know, I'm relieved you're bringing it up. It's been a huge elephant in the room.
No, that's not...
No, really. But humbly, Trixie and I have decided to let poor Virginia go.
Oh, sweet Jesus.
We've decided to let her death... That soul-crushing accident that nearly tore us apart behind us.
Trixie, can you... Don't cry.
It's okay to be emotional at a time like this.
You know, we named her after Virginia Woolf.
You hear that, nurse? Virginia Woolf.
Charles, how many times do I have to say I am sorry?
It's not about sorry anymore. Because we've already forgiven you.
Okay, I hate this. It was me. I backed over Virginia. I know, I'm sorry, it was an accident and I lied, but it was dark and I didn't see her. Morris was just covering for me.
Lola, how could you?
Hey, Mr. Rogers, can you not make this about you for a second?
What were you saying earlier? Something about how important family is?
Why'd you cable this, sir? I was gonna take that secret to my grave.
No, and you're just so willing, and no one's ever been so nice to me. Thank you. I feel like you'd actually help me hide a dead body.
Okay, I'm not touching a dead body.
Pussy.
Hey.
God, I'm so mean to you. I'm sorry. I love you.
Let's go hide that body in our basement.
All right, okay.
You're a strange couple.
Would you shut up?
Oh. Will you marry me?